Namaste children, welcome to today's maths class. In the last class we discussed introduction of lines and angles. Now on we discussed one theorem 6.1, that is if two lines intersect each other, the vertically angles formed are equal. Now in this class we are going to discuss the application of theorem 6.1. In solving the questions we are going to use the theorem. In which way we apply that and we find the required values, we will discuss with the help of some questions. Yes, now an example, example 1. In figure 6.9, this is a figure 6.9, PQ and RS are two lines, intersects each other at point O. Let this point is O, this is point of intersection O. If angle POR, this is angle POR, is to angle ROQ, ROQ, yes, these two adjacent angles. The ratio is given 5:7. Find all the angles. Find all the angles. What are the all angles? Angle POR, ROQ, QOS, and POS. Four angles we need to find. So how do we find it? As here we have two pairs of vertically opposite angles are formed. So as we discussed in the previous class, if we know one angle, if we find one angle, we can find all other angles. So to find any one angle with the help of given data, that is angle POR and angle ROQ, its ratio is given 5:7. That 5:7, use that concept and find any one angle. These two are, yes, what type of angles are they? Adjacent angles and they are linear pair of angles. Yes, some of these two angles, that is angle POR and angle ROQ, is how much sugar? Yes, it is 180 degrees. Use the concept of linear pair axiom and the theorem 6.1 to find all the angles. Yes, here angle POR is to angle ROQ is equals to 5:7. Let angle POR is equals to 5x and angle ROQ is equals to 7x, because always the ratio will be given in the simplest form. 5:7 means angle POR is 5 parts or 5 degrees, angle ROQ is 7 parts with 7 degrees, but it will be always given in the simpler form ratios. So they may not be the original values, that's why we are keeping with a variable 5x and 7x. Angle POR is 5x and angle ROQ is 7x. Now sum of these two angles, therefore angle POR plus angle ROQ is equals to 180 degrees. Why? Linear pair of angles. Yeah, linear pair of angles. Angle POR is how much? 5x. Plus angle ROQ is how much? 7x. That is equals to 180 degrees. Now simplify. 5x plus 7x is equals to 12x. That is equals to 180 degrees. Now transpose 12, which is multiplying. When we transpose to the other side, it divides. Now x is equals to 180 degrees by 12. 12 ones are 12. 12 ones are 12. 18 minus 12, 6 with 0, 60. 12 5s are 60. Now x is equals to what? 15 degrees. X is equals to 15 degrees. Now what we have to find? All angles. Angle POR is equals to, what it is, angle POR is 5x. That is 5 into x. 5 into x is 15 degrees. So how much we get? 5 into 15 is 75 degrees. 75 degrees. Now what about angle QOS? Angle POR. In the figure, please look at the figure. Angle POR and angle QOS, both are what? Vertically opposite angles and they are equal. Angle POR is equals to angle QOS. That is how much it is? 75 degrees. Why they are 75 degrees? Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Similarly, find the remaining two angles, that is angle ROQ. ROQ is how much? 7x.
angle ROQ is equals to 7x, that is 7 into 15. 15 sevens are 105 degrees. 15 sevens are 105. 105 degrees is angle ROQ. That is ROQ. What about angle POS? As these two are vertically opposite angles and they are equal. That is angle ROQ is equals to angle POS. That is 105 degrees because they are vertically opposite angles. Yes, like this we will find when the ratio of two adjacent angles are given, when two lines are intersected, using the concept of linear pair of angles and theorem 6.1. So now what are the four angles, how much they got? 75 degrees, 105 degrees and 105 degrees. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now we will move to the exercise number 6.1. The first question. In figure 6.13, lines AB and CD intersect at O. So line AB and CD intersect at point O. If angle AOC, this is angle AOC, plus angle BOE, this angle, sum of these two angles is equals to how much? 70 degrees. But we don't know individually how much they are. Angle AOC plus angle BOE, these two sum their angles is equal to 70 degrees, and angle BOD, yes, this angle, how much it is? 40 degrees. This given, this is 40 degrees. Find angle BOE, this is how much? And reflex of angle COE, is this angle. Reflex angle means this entire angle, that is. Is, which includes 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 angles are there. Yes. How do we find where these angles? Any idea? Yeah. See here, the two lines are intersected by each other at point O. This is AB. And this is CD. Yes. CD at O. Angle AOC, this angle, and angle BOD, both are what kind of angles? Yes, they are vertically opposite angles. And we know angle BOD is how much? It is given 40 degrees. Angle BOD is 40 degrees. Therefore, how much will be angle AOC? Yes, it is 40 degrees. Why? They are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Now it is given angle AOC plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degrees. And we know one angle, it is 40 degrees. How do we find the other angle? Yes, by subtracting from the sum, the known angle, we will get the unknown angle. Yes. Simple, how do we find here? Yes. Now here, what is given? In this, angle AOC plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degrees and angle BOD is equal to 40 degrees. So from the figure, angle AOC is equal to angle BOD because they are vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Hence, therefore, angle BOD, we know angle BOD is 40 degrees. Therefore, angle AOC is equal to how much? Angle AOC is also 40 degrees. Angle AOC is 40 degrees. You take this as equation 1. And this is equation 2. From 1 and 2, from equation 1 and equation 2, that is angle AOC is 40 degrees. Substitute in equation 1, angle AOC is 40 degrees, that is 40 degrees plus angle BOE is equal to 70 degrees. How much it is? 70 degrees. Now, angle BOE is equal to 70 degrees, transpose 40 degrees to RHS, we get minus 40 degrees. 70 minus 40 is 30. So 30 degrees. Angle BOE, what we have to find? The first one, how much we got? 30 degrees. So first one we found. Next we have to find angle reflex of angle COE. Reflex of angle COE. So to find that, first you find angle COE is how much?
then for that you subtract from the complete angle 360 degrees, we get how much is angle COE. Find how much will be that angle. Yes, here you see this is a straight line. On straight line we have three angles. Yes, this is the figure, second figure. Like this, you divide the figure into parts, you will understand very clearly. Yes, A, O, and this is C, and this is E. So now angle AOC is 40 degrees, we form, and angle BOE is 30 degrees, we form. Now how much will be angle COE? How do you find it? Yes, some of these three angles will give you how much? 180 degrees. The total angle on a straight line is 180 degrees. The total angle on a straight line is 180 degrees. That is angle AOC plus angle COE, angle COE plus angle BOE. BOE is equals to 180 degrees. Angle on a straight line. Angle on a straight line. Angle on a straight line is 180 degrees. Now, yes. Now it is. Now substitute, we know angle AOC is 40 degrees. Angle AOC is 40 degrees. Yes, 40 degrees plus angle COE plus angle BOE is 30 degrees, which is 180 degrees. 40 plus 30 is 70. Transpose 70 to RHS, we get angle COE is equals to 180 degrees minus 70 degrees. That is angle COE is equals to 180 minus 70, 110 degrees. How much it is? 110 degrees. Finally, what we have to find? Reflex of angle COE. Reflex of angle COE is equals to the total angle, that is complete angle 360 degrees minus angle COE, that is 110 degrees. So how much you get by subtracting? 0 minus 0, 0, 6 minus 1, 5, 3 minus 2 is 1, 250 degrees. We get the angle, reflex of angle B, sorry, angle C, O, E. So in this also we use, that is vertically opposite angles concept, linear pair of angles concept, and angle on a straight line concept, and we found the required angles as 30 degrees and 250 degrees. Is it clear, children? Yes, now we will continue exercise number 6.1, question number 3. In figure 6.15, angle PQR, marked like this, and angle PRQ are marked. So it means that both angles are equal. They are equal. The figure itself shows that these two angles are equal. Then prove that angle PQS, this angle is equal to angle PRD. Yes, we need to prove these two angles are equal. Those two angles are what? The exterior angles. Exterior angles are the triangles. Now, how do we prove these two angles are equal? So, observe the figure here. One straight line is given. On that straight line, the two line segments were drawn from point B, and four angles are formed. In that, the two internal angles are equal, and we need to prove external angles are also equal. Yes, how do we prove? The sum of these two angles is equal to how much? 180 degrees, because they are linear pair of angles, and these two angles is equal to 180 degrees, that is linear pair of angles. From the two equations, we will prove our required result. Now, what is given in this question? It is given angle PQR is equals to angle PRQ. What we have to prove? To prove that TPT, required to prove angle PQS is equals to angle PRT. Proof. So how do we prove this? Yes. Take these two angles. What are these two angles? Angle PQR plus angle PQS is equals to 180 degrees, equation 1. Why they are equal? 180 degrees? Linear pair of angles. Linear pair of angles. Similarly, angle PRQ
equation number 2, linear pair of angles.
Now observe the two angles. On right hand side, we have the same result, that is 180 degrees and 180 degrees. Therefore, their LHS must be equal. From equation 1, on equation 2, angle PQR plus angle PQS is equals to angle PRT plus angle PRQ. Now it is given that angle PQS, this is angle PQS, is equals to angle PR, as angle P. So what is given here? Angle PQR. Angle PQR is equals to angle PRQ. PRQ. These two angles are equal. So when we transpose angle plus angle PRQ to RHS, we get minus angle PRQ, and both will be eliminated. We can remove them, we can cancel them. Yes, as these two are equal. Now what is left? Angle PQS is equals to angle PRT. What we have to prove? Angle PQS is equals to angle PRT. Hence it is proved. So like this we can prove this result by using the concept of linear pair of angles. Linear pair of angles. Now move to the question number 5. In figure 6.17, POQ is a line, ray OR is perpendicular to line PQ, OS is another ray lying between rays OP and OR. Prove that angle ROS is equals to half of the difference of angle QOS and angle POS. So first you draw the figure. POQ is a line. Yes, this is a line. POQ is a line. Ray OR is perpendicular to PQ. OR, ray OR. This is a ray OR, and it is perpendicular to PQ at point O. That means angle POR. Yes, this angle is equals to 90 degrees, and angle ROQ is also equals to 90 degrees, and both are equal as they are linear pair of angles and perpendicular to angle PQ. Now, OS is another ray. OS is another ray lying between OP and OR. Lying between the rays OP and OR. Yes, this is OP ray and it is OR. So one more ray is there. OS ray. Yes, this is OS ray lying between the two rays OP and OR. So now, so two rays, that is OR is perpendicular to PQ. It means angle POR is equals to angle ROQ, that is 90 degrees. And OS is another ray lying between the rays OP and OR. Now, what we have to prove? Angle ROS. ROS. This angle, this small angle, is equals to half of the difference of angle QOS, this total angle. QOS is total angle minus angle POS. POS. Yes. What are these two angles? Angle POS and angle QOS. Angle POS and angle QOS. What are these two angles? Yes, they are linear pair of angles and their sum is 180 degrees. Now what we have to prove? Angle ROS, this small angle, is half of the difference of angle QOS and POS. So this is the figure. From this figure we need to prove angle ROS is equals to half of angle QOS minus angle POS. So now see simple way we discuss here. See in this figure the first step it is given. POQ is a line. OR is perpendicular. Therefore angle POR and QOR both are equal. Since OR is perpendicular to PQ, OR is perpendicular to PQ. Therefore angle POR is equals to angle QOR. Angle POR is equals to angle QOR. One result, we got it. Now you see here, the second step, yes, P, Q, and it is O, yes, and it is what? R, and here we have yes is there, yes. Now, to this angle, Q, O, R, and R, O, S is added, that is what we have to prove. It is angle Q, O, S and angle P, O, S. Consider the figure, angle Q, O, S and angle P, O, S. So, angle Q, O, S is equals to, angle Q, O, S is equals to what? That is angle Q, O, R plus angle R, O, S. Angle R, O, S. That is angle Q, O, R plus angle R, O, S. So, now, this is equation 1 part from this. You simplify this to this side, when transpose to the other side, angle Q, O, S minus angle Q, O, R is equals to angle R, O, S. Angle R, O, S, to take this as result 1. Now, what is angle P, O, S? This angle, angle P, O, S is equals to angle P, O, R minus angle R, O, S. Angle P, O, S, or better, you keep this as result 1. Result 1. Now you take angle P, O, S, this angle. Angle P, O, S is equals to angle P, O, R minus angle R, O, S. Yes, equation number 2. See, you see in the question what we need to prove. Angle R, O, S is equals to half of angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S. So write angle Q, O, S from the figure, which is angle Q, O, S is equals to angle Q, O, R plus angle R, O, S, and angle P, O, S is equals to angle P, O, R minus angle R, O, S. Now find the difference of these two equations, these two values. So subtract 1 minus 2, equation 1 minus equation 2, it is angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S is equals to angle Q, O, R plus angle R, O, S minus angle P, O, R plus angle R, O, S. So when we change, when we draw, minus sign is there, so this plus will become minus, that is minus angle P, O, R, and minus, minus into minus will become plus angle R, O, S, we get. And simplify this, what we get? Angle Q, O, R minus angle P, O, R, it is given, angle P, O, R is equals to angle Q, O, R, both angles are equal. If angle Q, O, R is 90 degrees, and angle P, O, R is also 90 degrees, both will be eliminated. So cancel them. Now what is left? 2 times of angle R, O, S. 2 times of angle R, O, S is equals to angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S. Now transpose 2 to LHS, which is multiplied on RHS, therefore it divides, that is 1 over 2 angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S is equals to angle R, O, S. Hence it is proved. A simple proof. Hence it is proved. Yes. How do we prove this? So in the question we need to prove angle R, O, S is equals to half of angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S. So first write angle Q, O, S is what? In terms of angle Q, O, R and R, O, S. And angle P, O, S also in terms of angle R, O, S, right? Then subtract both the angles, that is the two equations, we will reach to our result, that is angle R, O, S is equals to half of angle Q, O, S minus angle P, O, S. Is it clear to them? So like this, we will apply theorem 6.1, that is vertically opposite angles theorem and linear pair of angles axiom to prove or to find the unknown angles, to prove the results in the problems. Yes, I hope you understand. Thank you.